Hello everybody and welcome to the Viewer's Bonsai Exhibition number 2. Lots of pictures of nice trees were sent to me, so let's have a look. The first picture is sent to us by Colin McGovern, also known as the Boston Bonsai Idiot.
Check out his channel.
It is a big Norway maple with a fat trunk with lots of deadwoods. It's been in training since 2 years now, and it's going to be very spectacular once it's leafing out. Colin also sends us a picture of his root over rock forsythia. Now the rock is of course buried, but in a couple of years the topsoil can be removed and we will see the roots clinging onto the rock. So this is going to look very nice. Guy Watson from the UK sends a picture of his Chinese corkbark elm. It's 5 years in training now. I like it a lot. It really looks like a deciduous tree. It's in an oval glazed pot and it suits the tree very well. He also sends us a picture of his Hinoki cypress, 6 years in training. The trunk has a really interesting movement. It's still a young tree, but it's doing very well. In the pot there is a nice little rock as an accent, and the pot is oval and brown, which is very suitable for that kind of tree. The next picture he sends is a very unusual tree for bonsai. It's a holy tree, it's 6 years in training, and I must say it's really fun to see a holy because you don't see them often. The pot where it is planted in is a cream color glazed oval pot, and it is a really good combination, I must say. Guy also sent a picture of his Camarasiparis. It is a very nice, tall, formal upright tree in a shallow round pot. And I must confess that he blew my mind with the accent at the base of the pot. So thanks a lot, Guy from the UK. Mathieu Moureau sends us a picture of his Juniper japonica shimpaku. It is in a deep brown unglazed pot and the trunk is very interesting. It is very twisted. The tree is remarkably healthy and there is lots of choice to make very good foliage pads. He also sends a picture of his Zelkova nire. It's a black Zelkova. It's a twin trunk. The tree is already very well developed, lots of ramification, and it must be spectacular when it is leafing out. It is in a blue glazed pot, which suits the tree very well. Mike from the Netherlands sends us a picture of his hortensia. It's now in training for almost 2 years. It is probably a spectacular tree when it is flowering. Mike has his own YouTube channel.
Check out his channel.
It's called Minstera Mark, and you will probably be able to see a movie about how he came to this result. Christophe Cadia from Belgium sends us a picture of his Camarasiparis. It is a relatively young tree. He just styled it and wired it, but as you see, it already has a very nice shape, formal upright, and it's very well done. It's planted in a quite simple brown pot, which is very suitable for this tree in this stage. He also sends us a picture of his juniper. It's a little one, it's planted in a brown round pot, and the tree has a little bit of shari and gin, which is of course always very attractive on a juniper. It is an informal upright style and it looks really great in the snow. This is a picture of his Mugo pine. This tree is already a whole lot older. The tree is planted in a oval brown pot, non-glazed, which is of course very good for a pine. And the tree is quite interesting. The pads are already well formed and it's got a great future. The last picture from Christophe is this white pine. It is a very elegant tree. It's already starting to have some nice foliage pads. It's still planted in a training pot, but that's a very good idea because that allows the tree to grow a lot faster than it would otherwise. So, thank you a lot, Christophe from Belgium. Mark Hensford sent me 5 pictures and he said that the little cat that you can see on the pictures is 3 inches, so that's for scale. This is an ash, 3 years from garden. He doesn't know the exact age of the tree, but it's a very interesting tree, very natural looking, I think, and it's still planted in a training pot, which is, of course, again, a good idea. Mark also sends a picture of his hazel. It is self-sown in his garden, 7 years old, and the pot is homemade. I like the tree very much. It's very naturalistic. It has the shape of a real deciduous tree, so I think it's very well done. This tree is also planted in a pot that Mark made himself. It is a Japanese maple. It's 7 years old. It's coming from a garden center, but I really like the style Mark has. It's a really naturalistic style, very authentic. So, yeah, I like this very much. The root base is also quite interesting. Well spread out. It's a great tree with a great future. This is Mark's oak. It's a gift from a neighbor and it's been 2 years since the first root work. It's not easy to take care of oak trees, but this one is doing very well and, yeah, it's going to be a great tree. Finally, Mark sends us a picture of his rosemary, which is very nice. You don't see rosemary very often. It looks a little bit like a pine and it's a very interesting tree. It's a cutting, 2 years old, and it's still in a training pot where it should be. So thanks a lot, Mark, for the pictures. Great job. So this concludes the second edition of the Viewers Bonsai Exhibition. If you like to participate, well, just send me some pictures, and when I have enough pictures, I will put them online. Thanks a lot for watching, and see you next time.